When Simeon comes for Sir Michael's lunch, give him this letter.
Yes, Your Ladyship.
Thank you. lunch. Oh, and there's this letter for him also.
Oh. Becoming quite a thing, these letters from England. I reckon the squire's in love.
You're a cheeky blighter, Simeon.
Well, don't nobody laugh no more at Brattling. Or are you all too scared of that loony up in the attic?
Shh, Simeon.
Oh, don't worry, Annie. Nothing to be scared of. As long as I'm around. See you at the party tonight, Annie.
Yes, sir. Looks like it's going to be a good vintage.
I hope so. Brattling needs it.
Oh, they've got to be bad years, sir.
Yes, I know, Jan. But the Brattlers have had a run of bad years.
Perhaps you should let Aia Kat make you up a good luck charm.
Take more than Aia Kat's magic spells to change the fortunes of the Brattlers.
There's a letter for you, Sir Michael.
Oh.
Can I have the stamps when you're done, sir?
Hmm? Yes, yes, of course. Don't let them drink too much tonight, Jan.
No, sir, I won't.
You're lonesome, Michael. You have it. I may see you later at the party.
You're shaking your head, Paul.
I don't know how you can be so happy. Got a loony for a brother. I saw him in the woods this morning. There's something in a sack. And it was alive.
You better keep your mouth shut if you want to keep your job.
Not only me. The folks say Mr. Breck's fooling around with magic. Up there. They're more scared of him than the art of that old witch. My cat.
coming to the party soon. I don't know, Sir Michael. You're supposed to. But if I was you, my lad, I'd go and find her.
Enough now, Annie. Come on.
Lina?
It's a lie. It's to protect you.
Give it to me. Give it to me, Lina. From what? From whom? Are you trying to protect me? Craft's forbidden at Brattling, Lina. You know that.
Evil got to be fought with evil.
Baird?
There is no evil at Brattling, I know. Not anymore.
Oh, no. Simeon?
Must have been Simeon.
Huh? Why?
Why?
Horses do turn killers, sir.
Oh.
John!
So that's what spooked Saracen.
Snake will spook any horse.
He kicked on the door.
No. Someone let him out. Deliberately. I want him found, Jan. Quickly. Get rid of this, will you?
Mother, Marianne has consented to marry me.
Is that what the letter was about?
Yes.
But it's been more than a year since you last saw her, and then only for a short time in London. How do you know she hasn't changed?
We love each other, that's all we need to know.
You, Breck, and I are the last of the Brattlings. We should make sure there will be no more. If you marry this girl, you'll only be adding another tragedy to the history of Brattling.
It's because of Breck that you don't want to hear, isn't it?
What do you suggest we do with him? Brush him under a carpet like unsightly dirt?
Breck is my brother. I love him as much as you do.
Mother, can't you see? He's sick and needs proper care.
He's a Brattley as much as you or me. He has a right to stay here as long as he lives. It's Mary Ann who has no right here.
I'm afraid I have some rather bad news.
Michael.
No, not Sir Michael. Breck.
His brother.
It appears that a runaway stallion that killed a man 6 weeks ago attacked Breck while he was out on a walk.
Oh, no.
I'm sorry I had to bring you such distressing news.
Did you know Breck, Doctor?
He was an undergraduate while I was at Dublin. I only met him once or twice after he qualified, and that was many years ago in London at a medical conference. I believe he returned to the Cape shortly after that, gave up his practice in London.
Michael never mentioned that his brother was a doctor.
He had some rather extraordinary ideas, which he published. But I'm afraid they had a mixed reception in medical circles.
Oh. Why was that?
He believed the soul was an organic entity, which could be isolated and kept alive outside and independent of the human body.
The time passed most pleasantly, thanks to you, Dr. Collinson. I do hope you have a pleasant stay with the degree.
Dr. Collinson?
Yes?
Mr. Hurst sent me to meet you, sir.
Ah, my bags are over there. I'll be with you in a minute. Don't worry, Miss Carew. If Sir Michael doesn't arrive, I can always drop you on my way to the Roots farm.
I'm sure he will be here soon.
Will you excuse me while I look for my luggage? That one and that one.
Yes, sir.
Very kind, Dr. Collinson.
My pleasure, Miss Carew.
Marianne!
Hello.
Dearest. This is Dr. Collinson. He's been my guardian angel.
How do you do?
I'm very grateful to you, Doctor.
He's going to visit your neighbors, the Groots. I've asked him to come and visit us.
Yes, of course. We'd be delighted, Doctor.
Thank you, Mr. Michael. Miss Carew?
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Oh, Marianne, this is Lina. She'll be your personal maid at Brattling.
How did you do, Lina?
Ma'am.
Come, my dear.
I beg your pardon, Sir Michael.
Yes?
That case that's addressed to Dr. Brett. Will you take it now or have it sent for later?
We'll take it with us. We might as well. Load it up, would you? Another mile.
I can hardly wait to get there. You're much thinner, dearest.
That's one of the changes at Brattling since I wrote to you.
You mean Breck's accident?
You know about that?
The station master told Dr. Collinson. How is he?
Well, at first we thought he might die. His head was badly crushed. Upset. She doted on the wreck.
Can't we go a little faster, Michael? I can hardly wait.
Yes, of course. Get up. Go on. Get up.
Michael, do you think your mother will like me?
Of course she'll like you. How could anyone not like you?
It is rather grim, isn't it? But everything will change now that you're here. Let me introduce you. This is Bland, our butler.
Yes.
And behind you is Annie.
Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you, Annie. The only thing to show Mr. Mary out of the room. My dear, when you're refreshed, I'll introduce you to the mother. Thank you, Bland.
I simply will not allow you to marry this girl.
You will allow whatever I say, Mother.
Then you intend to go through with it, despite my wishes?
Not despite anything, but because I am master of Brattling.
I can hardly believe it. It seems incredible that this is Africa and not England.
Cape Colony, my dear, not Africa. But if you will listen carefully, you will realize there is a difference.
What is that drumming, Michael?
Nothing that need concern you. You might call it the sound of Africa.
You should not permit it. Your father never did.
What should Michael not permit, Lady Brattling?
Witchcraft.
Mr. Breckinridge is trained.
Thank you, Bland. That will be all.
They're very much alike, Lady Brattling.
They were then. But not anymore.
I'm such a blunderer. Please forgive me.
Has Michael told you about the Eddie accident?
Only that Breck attacked by a stallion while out walking. He also said that Breck refuses to see anyone except you and Michael. Overwrought. Surely there's something I could do to help.
This is a family matter. Michael had no right to tell you about it.
But I am family.
Not yet, my dear. Not yet.
I love Michael, Lady Bratley, and everything that is part of him. Even if you don't care for me, you'll never change what I feel for him. Nothing will ever change that.
May I turn back the bed, Miss Marianne?
Yes, thank you, Lina. What's he like, Lina?
Who, Miss?
Mr. Breck.
I haven't seen him since the accident, Miss. Nobody has. He never leaves the upper floor.
Oh, how dreadful. Poor Breck. What was he like, Lina, before the accident?
Did you know he was crippled, Miss?
Yes, Sir Michael told me.
Aia Kat says he's marked by the devil. He used to play the organ, sometimes late at night. We could hear down in the servants' quarters. Lonely, terrible music, like the swing.
Come in.
Leave us, Lina. You're retiring rather early, aren't you?
I don't think your mother wants me here at Brattling.
Oh? Did she say that?
She told me not to interfere in family matters.
Well, mother's had a terrible shock. Breck is more than just a son to her. You'll have to be very patient with us, my darling. All of us. Mother, Breck, even me.
Who is Aia Kat?
Oh, just an old Malay woman, who people believe to have supernatural powers. Did Lina tell you about her?
Yes, but why are you so angry?
I'm not angry. I just don't want you listening to servants gossip, that's all. Especially from Lina. I'll speak to Mother tomorrow about a new maid for you.
Oh, please don't, Michael. I like the girl.
All right, my love. Good night. Sleep well. You'll be called at 8:30.
Did you lock my door last night, Lina?
No.
And the organ music? Did you hear it? Lina? I saw Mr. Breck with my own eyes limping along the path beneath my bedroom window.
Then he must be better, miss.
Lina?
Please trust me as I now trust you. I promise you that whatever you tell me will remain a secret between us.
There's nothing to tell, miss. I've told you everything I know.
You haven't told me why, whenever you speak of Mr. Breck, you behave like a frightened child. What is it that he does or used to do up in that attic?
Nobody knows for sure. But Aia Kat says he's doing what no man has the right to do.
What is Mr. Breck doing, Lina?
Collecting the souls of living creatures.
Lina! Lina!
Good. Very good. Living in England all these years have not robbed you of your skill, I see.
I used to practice on Hampstead Heath. keep up with you, Hugo.
You're not sorry you've given up your London practice to take up this lecturing post at the medical school, are you?
Good heavens, no. I always intended to return to the colony. What makes you think that I have any regrets?
Sometimes you look like a man who has a profound regret, as if he has lost something.
It's the girl you met on the boat coming out, isn't it, my friend?
Miss Carew is engaged to be married to Sir Michael Brattling, Hugo.
Yes?
But somehow I think that she's in great danger.
Let's go and have some tea.
Fields yet?
No, I haven't seen him, miss.
Thank you, Annie.
Thank you.
from me as if he were some dangerous animal. I've seen him staring out of the attic window.
My son does not wish to see you. He's been ill, very ill. Can't you understand that?
Then why was he walking in the garden last night?
That's impossible. It was your imagination.
And the organ music? Was that also my imagination?
What is it? What's happening?
I was coming to tell you, sir. Aia Kat is dead. They all want to leave.
Stand still!
What do you want?
It isn't safe to work or live here anymore.
Is that damn horse that's killed her?
Yeah.
Saracen is no longer on Brattling. He's disappeared. You all know that. He's probably dead.
Then his soul ain't dead. He's out there somewhere.
It's him. That's Hex's place. Your crazy brother. Up there.
Let's go get him.
Those of you who wish to leave can go.
What is it? You're angry with me.
Is it unreasonable for a woman who's come 7,000 miles to join the man she loves to expect him to spend a little of his time with her?
You saw what happened last night. Brattling is like a ship that's sinking. And no one can save her except me.
You and me, Michael? Or have you forgotten you asked me to marry you? Last night, your mother begged me to leave Brattley. Is that what you want, too?
Mother begged you to leave Brattley. Why?
Maybe because of Breck. I mean, I thought...
Breck? Why does everyone blame poor Breck for everything that happens in this house? I spent an hour with him this morning. But I can get nothing from him. He just sits there, staring into space. A shattered mind and a shattered body.
Oh, my dearest, I'm sorry. I've been so selfish and thoughtless. I promise never to speak about it again. I promise.
We have a visitor. Will you be all right on your own, my love?
Yes, you go. I'll lie down for a while. The horse. Was it Saracen?
Yes, it was Saracen.
I'm sorry, Michael.
See you, Tanner. What brings you to Brattling?
One of your farmhands put in an appearance at the castle day before yesterday. With a rather incredible story, Sir Michael.
As long as he's up there in that attic, none of us is safe. Oh, please, miss, let's go to Cape Town. I will work for you there.
You must stay calm, Lina. You must think.
I have thought, miss. I'm leaving Brattling.
How far is Grootwood from here?
About 8 miles by road, miss. But there's a shortcut through the fields.
Then will you do one last favor for me before you leave Brattling?
Oh, yes, miss.
Take this letter to Grootwood and hand it to Dr. Collinson.
Yes, miss. God protect you.
It may well be as you say, Sir Michael. Superstitious servants chatter. Nevertheless, two particularly brutal killings have occurred. And I'm quite sure none of us here really believe that the stallion was responsible.
And who do you suggest is responsible?
Perhaps after I've looked around the property and questioned a few people, I might be able to give you the answer. With your permission, Sir Michael, I should also like to have a few minutes with your brother.
You realize, of course, Lieutenant, that Breckinridge has not yet completely recovered from the stallion's attack.
It is this that I need assuring of, Lady Bradley. That is why I should like to see him when I return from speaking to your field workers. Now, if you'll excuse me, Lady Bradley. Sir Michael.
Oh, Michael.
Please.
Hugo! It's all right, you're safe now. It's one of the servant girls from Brattling.
Let's take her into the house.
Come on. Where'd you drop the note, Lina?
There.
It's not here.
It must be there. That's the only place I could have dropped it.
And the trap?
Further down.
Where'd you see the killing, Lina?
Down in the south vineyard. There it is.
Oh. Steady, Dad, steady. There's nothing here.
I don't understand.
Never mind, Lina. Now listen. I want you to go back to Brattling and stay with Miss Mary Ann till I get there. Tell her I'm on my way, but nothing else. Not to her or anybody. Do you understand?
Yes.
Come on, now. Come on, up now, up. Come on.
Nasty business this, Sir Michael. I thought when that farmhand of yours came here with a wild story of ghost horses and killings with a mile of tripe. Turner thought it should be looked into. Good officer. Great pity. Take him away. Now I shall have to look into things myself.
Could you postpone your visit, Colonel Pringle, for a few days?
Something wrong, Sir Michael?
My brother, Breckinridge. He died suddenly this afternoon.
Sir Michael, just a minute.
I'm sorry, Colonel Pringle. Please try and understand. We're all very upset. Can I let you know when we can see you?
Certainly. My condolences to you and your mother.
Thank you.
I'm afraid you've just missed my son. He left for Cape Town over an hour ago. Was there anything important?
No, Lady Bradley. May I? Sir Michael invited me to visit whenever I was passing.
My son never mentioned having met you, Dr. Collinson.
But perhaps because of the brevity of our encounter. Miss Carew and I were fellow travelers as far as Brattling. She introduced me at the station. It's your other son, Breckinridge, whom I knew. We met while he was studying at Dublin. I was most impressed by some of his theories.
It was kind of you to call, Dr. Collinson. Should you miss Michael in town, I'll tell him you've called.
How is Miss Carew, Lady Bradley?
When I last saw her, she was walking with her maid in the garden. Then she appeared to be perfectly well.
You wouldn't object if I spoke to her before I left.
Why should I object, Dr. Collinson?
Miss Carew.
How good of you to come, Dr. Collinson.
I wish I could prevail upon you to leave immediately. Come back to Cape Town with me until we can establish exactly what's going on here at Brattling.
No, I can't, Dr. Collinson. I'm engaged to be married to Michael. My place is here with him. I'm not afraid.
Then why did you send me that letter with Lina?
Because I thought you might be able to persuade Michael to allow you to examine Breck.
If they won't allow you to see him, how do you expect them to allow me?
I thought that you being a doctor, they would listen to you.
Miss Carew, I sincerely believe you should come with me. I still think you should change your mind and come to Cape Town with me.
I've explained to you, Dr. Collinson, but I must stay here.
Then stay close to Lina.
I promise.
Breckinridge Brattley, sir. His brother, Sir Michael, brought the boot in this afternoon to be repaired.
How can you be so sure this heel comes off Mr. Breckinridge's boot?
Easy, sir. Notice how high the heel is. It was Lady Brattley's idea. With the boot on, he walked as normal as Sir Michael. Here's his last. You see, sir, he doesn't have a true foot. More like a hoof it is, without toes. But with my boot on, you'd never know.
Before I go into town.
Don't tell me you're deserting us too, Bland.
I'm taking Annie in, miss. I understand she's not very happy at Brattling. Will that be all, miss?
Yes, thank you. Oh, Bland, by the way, have you seen Lina anywhere?
Not since this morning, miss.
Breckinridge Brattley is dead. Sir Michael told me so himself.
Breckinridge Brattley is very much alive, Colonel. God knows if it's time enough to prevent him committing another insane crime.
How do you know he is?
Believe me, Colonel, I do.
Very well, Collins.
Thank you.
Before it's too late. You're in danger. Terrible danger.
You're trying to frighten me into leaving. It's a lie. A mad, vicious lie.
But the Brattleys are mad. Look at them. All of them died of some sort of madness. That was me. Do you see what marriage to a madman and giving birth to one can do to a woman? Is that what you want, Marianne? I beg you, for the last time, leave Brattling.
I won't listen to you. I won't!
Yes. Take the other horse out of the tree.
Right.
Collinson!
go. You must let her go.
Wedding, Mother. Have you forgotten the wedding?
No. No, I won't let you.